Hello everyone and welcome to Long's Toys. Today we'll be taking a look at Cyber Battalion Optimus Prime. As you can see from the big sticker, this is a Universal Studios exclusive product, except spoiler alert, it's not really. These have made their way to Walgreens. The original four that were made for Universal Studios, I believe, are Optimus, Bumblebee, Starscream, and Megatron. Now, I've seen the Optimus and the Bumblebee at Walgreens. I don't think the Starscream or the Megatron ever made it to Walgreens. Starscream kind of got repainted, remolded into Jetfire, which we did see at Walgreens. The Megatron, I don't think, has ever made its way. I even asked the guy at Universal Studios, and he said as long as he's worked there, he's never seen a Megatron. So he must have been very popular, kind of a flash in the pan. Went to Universal, sold out, and they never made any more. And they're definitely done with these. If you can take a look at the back here, the original price was $32.95, which is absolutely ridiculous, but it's a theme park gift shop, so that's kind of par for the course. But they were marked down to $22.99, which is still ridiculous, but is less ridiculous. It is a savings of almost $10. These things, I believe, are either $17 or $18 at Walgreens, which I've always thought are a bit much. But they are kind of big and solid, and then they're fun toys, so like I still get them. I think there's a Shockwave I still need to track down at some point. But Walgreens around me don't really get these in anymore. It's kind of a shame. But they said the reason they were marked down at the theme park was because they are done with them. They're not making any more. They want to get rid of them, make room for new product and stuff. So they had a ton of these. Bumblebee, Optimus, and Starscream. I also picked up Starscream. I did not get Bumblebee, as Bumblebee is not a very good toy by all accounts of anyone who's ever owned him, mostly Shuki. So shout out to Shuk if he's watching. Per him, the Bumblebee is not good, so I will not be getting it. But even per the box, the robot mode looks terrible. So here are the transformation instructions on the back. Pretty simple. Should be pretty fun, though. But yeah, I was just excited that it's really only about a $5 markup for a theme park. That's really nothing. So Optimus Prime, leader of the heroic Autobots and sworn defender of Earth. Le chef des héroïques Autobots. Apparently, he also makes the Autobots dinners. So there you go. He is a master chef. But yeah, so let's go ahead. Let's get this guy out of the box and we'll take a closer look. All right, so here is Optimus out of the packaging, and I have to say, I really, really like the design of him. He's got a lot of nice paint applications. He's got this silver down here on the shins, really nice kind of metallic blue for the visor here, a little bit of yellow for the front headlamps. He's got the Autobot symbol on each shoulder, and I'm going to zoom in here so you can take a look at this head sculpt. It's really, really well done. I like it quite a bit. Really sharp, a little stylized, but it's cool. I like it. Now, unfortunately, he suffers from the fists being molded into the front of the car, just like Cyberverse Optimus Prime Ultimate Class. But what are you going to do? These are just kind of, I don't want to say cheaper figures, but simplified figures. So I kind of wish that the hands were at least painted. Like, I do like that the Cyberverse version at least painted the fists, so they stood out a little bit more. But overall, I think it's a pretty decent little toy. Not really much back kibble, which I appreciate. Articulation-wise, the head can actually swivel from side to side. You have a little bit of movement here in this shoulder joint, but that's because of the transformation. Then you have a swivel here. You have a pretty tight ratchet joint in the elbow, as well as a bicep swivel. Then you have a swivel up here. This is due to the transformation, but you can kind of utilize it a little bit. Hips can go out to the side, front to back, and there is no knee or ankle articulation, so the leg is one solid piece, but I really don't think it's that much of a problem. He stands pretty tall, and I like the look of him. Like I said, I really do like the design, and I like the color scheme, and the paint applications are all pretty good. So, I mean, if you're buying this at a theme park for $30, do I think it's worth $30? No, not really. Is it worth $23? Meh. I mean, the fact that it's a theme park exclusive gives it a little bit of resale value, I guess, if you ever needed to resell it. But overall, I just think it's a fun toy. I think it's a nice, solid toy, especially for younger kids. I think they could definitely have some fun with this guy. And his transformation is not too complicated, so we'll go ahead and we'll get to that now. So it's very simple to start out. You just kind of push the head into the chest, just like that. You're going to go ahead and you can just peg the feet together. You can see that there is a tab right there and there is a tab slot right there. So you just go ahead and peg the feet together like so. You can go ahead and turn the torso where I showed you earlier. And then you're just going to kind of bring the elbows up at a 90 degree angle. And then you want to bend the knees. I'm sorry, the legs, not the knees, because the knees don't bend. Now, you don't want to just bring these up at the hips. This whole piece, you'll see, folds forward. It actually folds at the crotch, not at the hips. So you do that, and you bring that down, and you can see where that kind of stops, because that little indentation will kind of hit the abs, like that. And then you're going to just rock this in, basically how every prime since the beginning of time has transformed. There's a little tab slot there, and there's a gray tab there. But be careful when you're transforming this back. Also, there's a tab here and a tab slot in there. But I noticed the tabs on the inside of the hands and this gray tab here tab in super tight. So just be careful when you're transforming it back to robot mode, because it can get stuck and you do not want to break anything. So just be careful. But here is the cab that you are left with when we are done transforming. It's pretty skinny, but I think it works. Again, the metallic used for the windows and the yellow for the headlights, I think looks pretty good. You still get the Autobot symbol on the side. The wheels are painted nice, and it rolls fairly decently. So I appreciate that. But yeah. Pretty good. And there's really not any kibble in this mode. I mean, yeah, you can see the feet, but I feel like because it's all blue, they kind of blend in decent enough if you try not to think about it. But yeah, it's a pretty nice little transformation. Fairly simple. Like I said, I think kids are really going to love it. Rolls very nice. And it's a nice souvenir if you had a great time in the park. If you loved the Transformers ride, a little memento. It's definitely a fun toy. I like it quite a bit. I like this Prime figure quite a bit. The Cyber Battalion series has kind of really surprised me. When I first saw pictures of them, they looked like just kind of upscaled Legends class figures. Or Legion class, depending on which terminology you use. And that's kind of what they are, but they're definitely upscaled and made more solid. They have better paint applications, and they're really just kind of fun. It's nice to have a kind of simple transformation figure that's a little bit larger, and, you know, it's just fun. I think it's very accessible for kids. It's kind of like what Cyberverse could have been if they didn't decide to put, like, a goofy gimmick in every figure. That's what ultimately what I think is going to be the downfall of the Cyberverse line, and I don't mean downfall as far as they're going to go out of business or anything. The line will do fine. I'm sure they'll sell and it'll be fine and kids will have a blast with it. But for older collectors, I think older collectors can appreciate these toys. Even though they are kind of simple, they're still good figures. They feel solid. They're painted nice. The transformation is just fun enough that you can do it. I should say just complicated enough that you can do it back and forth quickly and it's satisfying. But you don't get bored of it. It's not just like stand it up and there's the robot or anything like that. So it's got decent articulation, nice paint apps, fun alt mode, fun robot mode. It's nice. It's kind of a simple line that just is the perfect mix of simple and complicated, if that makes any sense. I'm probably not articulating this well, but what I'm trying to say is it's a nice middle ground line that's accessible enough to kids, but older collectors can still enjoy and not feel like it's too rudimentary, if that makes sense. So I think they're fun. I've really been enjoying all the releases I've been able to find so far. I'd love to find a Megatron, but I don't think that's going to happen. And I did get the Starscream, so I'll be reviewing that probably in the next day or so here. And I got to find that Shockwave. But yeah, it's just kind of funny, especially to find these now with Cyberverse also being released around the same time. There are a lot of parallels to the two lines that I feel like they could almost work together. But I feel like Cyberverse, usually at the higher size classes, has even more paint. But really about the same amount, maybe even less articulation because of a lot of the gimmicks. So this is kind of like a Cyberverse without gimmicks in my mind. But if I had to change anything on this figure, I would love to see the fists painted just so they stand out a little bit with the rest of the arm here. you know, sure, I'd love a knee articulation point, but I don't need it. But that's if I had to nitpick one or two little things. Again, I think they're pretty fun. At this point, I think you may be able to find it at Walgreens, but it's probably fairly difficult because this is an older wave and they're not really getting them anymore. But if you go to Universal Studios, I got this at the Universal Studios Hollywood in California. I believe, I don't know this for a fact, but I believe that Orlando also has them. But they might be trying to clearance them as well, since it sounds like they're done with these and are probably moving on to newer products. So I think they're fun. If you can get your hands on one of these for not too exorbitant a price, any more exorbitant than the retail already is. But if you can get your hands on one of these for not too bad, I recommend it. I think it's pretty fun. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And as always, thanks for watching.